Please stand.
Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
May the grace and peace of God our Father, the love of the Lord Jesus, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with each of you always.
And with you, sir.
On the storm-tossed seas of our lives, Jesus approaches. Take courage. It is I. Do not be afraid. In the midst of all that troubles us, brothers and sisters, let us call to mind our sin. So prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries.
You are Lord of heaven and earth, of sea and sky. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Your truth shall spring up from the earth. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You call us not to doubt, but to have faith. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sin, and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen. Glory, glory to God. In the highest, glory to God, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, glory, glory to God. In the highest, glory to God, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us.
Glory, glory to God. In the highest, glory to God.
Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, whom taught by the Holy Spirit we dare to call our Father, bring, we pray, to perfection in our hearts the spirit of adoption as your sons and daughters, that we may merit to enter into the inheritance which you have promised. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Book of Kings. At the mountain of God, Horeb, Elijah came to a cave where he took shelter. Then the Lord said to him, "Go outside and stand on the mountain before the Lord. The Lord will be passing by." A strong and heavy wind was rending the mountains and crushing rocks before the Lord, but the Lord was not in the wind. After the wind, there was an earthquake, but the Lord was not in the earthquake. After the earthquake, there was fire, but the Lord was not in the fire. After the fire, there was a tiny whispering sound. When he heard this, Elijah hid his face in his cloak and went and stood at the entrance of the cave. The word of the Lord.
Show us your kindness, O God. 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 I will hear what God proclaims, peace to the people, peace to all who change their hearts and place their trust in God. Show us your kindness, O God. Show and truth and praise, peace and justice, truth shall break forth from the earth, and justice from on high.
Show us your kindness, O God. Show
God will give us good things, our land will yield its harvest. Justice, oh justice, justice, oh justice, will walk before our God
step of the way, every step of the way.
Show us your kindness, O God. Show us your kindness, O
God. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, I speak the truth in Christ. I do not lie. My conscience joins with the Holy Spirit in bearing me witness that I have great sorrow and constant anguish in my heart. For I could wish that I myself were accursed and cut off from Christ for the sake of my own people, my kindred, according to the flesh. They are Israelites. Theirs the adoption, the glory, the covenants, the giving of the law, the worship, and the promises. Theirs the patriarchs, and from them, according to the flesh, is the Christ, who is over all, God blessed forever. Amen. The word of the Lord.
According to Matthew. After he had fed the people, Jesus made the disciples get into a boat and precede him to the other side while he dismissed the crowds. After doing so, he went up on the mountain by himself to pray. When it was evening, he was there alone. Meanwhile, the boat already a few miles offshore was being tossed about by the waves, for the wind was against it. During the fourth watch of the night, he came toward them walking on the sea. When the disciples saw him walking on the sea, they were terrified. "It is a ghost," they said, and they cried out in fear. At once Jesus spoke to them, "Take courage, it is I. Do not be afraid." Peter said to him in reply, "Lord, if it is you, command me to come to you on the water." He said, "Come." Peter got out of the boat and began to walk on the water toward Jesus. But when he saw how strong the wind was, he became frightened and began beginning to sink. He cried out, "Lord, save me." Immediately, Jesus stretched out his hand that caught Peter and said to him, "Oh, you of little faith, why did you doubt?" After they got into the boat, the wind died down. Those who were in the boat did him homage, saying, "Truly, you are the Son of God." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. This is a gospel passage for our time. None of us, I'm sure, can listen to this gospel without considering the impact of a global pandemic with COVID-19. And along with it, not only is it a worldwide health crisis, but it is an economic crisis for a nation and for all the nations of the world. And that crisis is compounded and personalized by the number of people who have lost jobs, lost income, and in so many senses, we've lost our way. And so we can identify with the disciples in that storm-tossed boat on the Sea of Galilee, rowing against the wind and trying to gain some sense of control and realizing that our peril is imminent. There's a lot going on in our lives and our world that enable us to identify with those frightened disciples in that storm-tossed boat on the Sea of Galilee. But let's remember our context again. Where are we in Matthew's gospel? I'm sure you recall last week Jesus and his disciples were to go off to an out-of-the-way place so they can get some R&R and he can have an opportunity for some prayer, some intimate communion with his Father in prayer. But the crowds realized where they were going and followed after them. And Jesus, as Jesus does all the time, did not say, "Go away, I'm on vacation." But instead, he cared for them. He preached to them. He healed the sick and responded to their needs. And when the disciples said, "Well, it's time to send them home, time for dinner," Jesus said, "You give them something to eat yourself." And of course, we know of the wonderful miracle of the multiplication of the loaves and the fish that fed so many. And Jesus wanted to utilize those disciples of his as servants of the coming kingdom of God by being collaborators in this miracle, beginning with the request, "You give them something to eat yourself." And then after Jesus took and blessed and broke, Eucharistic imagery, he called upon those same disciples to distribute the food among the people, and when it was all over, to pick up the leftovers. Jesus wants us to be collaborators with him in the realization of the kingdom of God. And when it was all over, he told the disciples to get on into the boat and I'll see you on the other side. He sent the people home and then he had that opportunity going up the mountain. And we know in Jewish tradition and especially in Matthew's gospel, the mountain is the place of communion with God, to spend the night in prayer, to find rest and refreshment by renewing his relationship with his heavenly Father, and to renew his own call to the mission of realizing the kingdom of God. Of course, while Jesus is in prayer, we are told that the storm starts raging across the Sea of Galilee, and even though there are experienced sailors and fishermen in the group, they are losing their way, rowing against the relentless wind and feeling that they're about to go under. We are told that this took place in the fourth watch of the night. That's generally between 6 a.m., 4 a.m. and 6 a.m. So we realize that we are in the dead of night, and I imagine it was probably more in the winter where dawn comes much later, because it was also known as the darkest hour. So in the darkest hour of their peril, Jesus comes walking across the water toward them on the stormy sea. And if it wasn't bad enough that they felt that they were going under the weight of the storm, they thought they were seeing a ghost. It wasn't until Jesus spoke to them, "Take courage, it is I, do not be afraid." In recognizing that voice, it was Peter that said, "Well, Lord, if it is you, tell me to come to you across the waters." Now, there are two ways of listening to this exchange between Jesus and Peter. Of course, they knew Jesus and they realized that he had done wonderful miracles and signs among the people. So if he is able to cure the sick and feed the hungry, he certainly can walk on water. This is a theophany. This is a manifestation of God. This is another epiphany, a revelation of who Jesus is for us. Matthew wrote his gospel in Greek. And in Greek, the word "it is I" is rendered "ego eimi," which is literally translated "I am." It was the name of the eternal God revealed to Moses on Mount Sinai in the burning bush, the unspeakable name of the eternal. And for Jesus to identify himself as "I am," it holds a whole new dimension for Peter's response to Jesus. It is not just this Jesus who cured the sick and fed the hungry. It is a Jesus who is revealing to us the presence of the eternal God. Peter gets out of that boat in the midst of the stormy sea and walks towards Jesus. He's doing fine as long as he keeps his focus on Jesus. We know how that is. In our own lives of prayer and discipleship, we try to keep our focus on Jesus. There's a lot going on around us, a lot of storms swirling around us, and sometimes we get distracted. And like Peter, when we take our focus off Jesus, we start to go under. Peter's response is perhaps one of the most heartfelt prayers that come to us in the gospel. "Lord, save me." Even when we can't find it within us to muddle through the Lord's Prayer, the one prayer that Jesus has given us, we can, in the midst of our peril, in the midst of our fear, in the midst of our sense of going under, declare, "Lord, save me." And the Lord does save him, reaching out his hand and pulling him up from the waters and chastising him as well. "Oh, you of little faith, why did you doubt?" You know, it dawned on me yesterday when I was reading this reading that I would think that once the disciples recognized that it was Jesus walking on the water and he identified himself, that the storms would subside. But they don't. Peter went and walked on water on a stormy, choppy sea. It's a reminder to us that Jesus is not above the fray. He is not distant from our experience and our reality, but that Jesus is with us in the midst of our storm-tossed lives and all of the challenges that come our way. It wasn't until Jesus and Peter got back in the boat that the storm subsided. A reminder to us in the storm-tossed moments of our life that we need to invite Jesus into the boat with us, and that we need to rely on him and keep our focus on him so that we can sustain all of the difficulties and challenges in our storm-tossed life. Jesus is teaching his disciples how to be the future leaders of the church. Just as they were collaborators and cooperators in the miracle of the multiplication of the loaves and the fishes, so going forth in the midst of the difficulties and challenges and stormy experiences of our life, He has taught them, you can't do it alone. This is only something you and I can do together. And so we are called to forge that relationship with the Lord that sustains us in every difficulty and peril and challenge. The disciples in the storm-tossed boat are not the only frightened servants of the Lord in our scriptures today. The great prophet Elijah, in our first reading from the first book of Kings, is a prophet on the lam. He has been victorious over the prophets of Baal, who Jezebel, the pagan queen, brought into Israel and displaced devotion to the God of Israel. And as a result of that, she's out to get him. And he is running for his life. He ran as far as he could into the desert and just lay down and wanted to go to sleep. But he prayed, Lord, take my life from me now. But as he slept, not only once, but twice, did an angel of the Lord come to him and offer food and water to sustain him, and to send him on a journey of 40 days to the mountain of God, Horeb. Horeb is also known as Mount Sinai, the very place where Moses had an encounter with the great I Am in the burning bush. And that 40 days is symbolic of our own journey with its challenges and its difficulties. It is a sign, a symbol of completion, that we reach the destination for which we have been called. And ascending the mountain of Horeb, the mountain of God, God tells Elijah that he will reveal himself to Elijah. Elijah probably thought, oh good, I'm going to get my wish, because no man can see God and live, so I'm going to look at God and die right there on the spot, right here on God's holy mountain. Elijah hid in the cave and went and was summoned to go out onto the mountain because God was to pass by. We hear that there was a relentless storm that crushed the rocks, that there was an earthquake that shattered the very foundation of creation, that there was a raging fire that swept across the mountain, and God was not in the storm or in the earthquake or in the fire. And in biblical parlance, those huge manifestations of nature were considered to be revelations of the divine. But the divine and eternal God did not reveal himself in the storm, in the earthquake, or in the fire. But, we are told, in a tiny, whispering sound. There's a lot of noise going on around us in our world. Things to distract us one way or the other. Those out there who are trying to inspire fear rather than confidence. And you know, for people of faith, the opposite of fear is faith. And we feed our faith through developing that relationship with the Lord in prayer, both personally and communally, as we do here. And to overcome the fear and the anxiety and the turmoil around us, we need to be rooted in Jesus, who is our way and our truth and our life. And we need to realize that God does not always speak to us in the big and bombastic voices in our world around us, but in the silence, in the sounds of silence, and that tiny whispering sound wherein we can be grounded and rooted and find our stability. The storm-tossed seas will continue to rage around us. And we need to realize that no one of us can sustain that kind of challenge alone. But with the Lord, all things is possible. Take courage. Ego eimi. I am for you. I am with you. Do not be afraid. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sin, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Let us praise God our Father as we confidently call upon the Lord in our need.
That all Christians may be faithful to the call to discipleship, whether it is convenient or inconvenient, especially during times of turmoil or personal struggle, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all the baptized may welcome the person of Christ in the poor, the defenseless, and victims of discrimination and injustice, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That people of faith may be attentive to the voice of the Lord as it speaks to us in the ordinary events of our lives, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For a renewed zeal for service in the church, for an increase in vocations to the priesthood and religious life, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick, the lonely, and the forgotten, for the hospitalized and the homebound, especially Deacon Bob Manthai, and for all who have asked for the support of our prayer, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all who have died in Christ may also rise in Christ, let us also remember Babs Patsliotic, for whom this Mass is offered, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Hear our prayer, merciful God, and make us generous in our care of one another through Christ our Lord.
Take my hand, lean me on, let me stand. I am tired, I am weak, I am worn. Through the storm, through the night, lean me on to the light. Take my hand, precious.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Be pleased, O Lord, to accept the offerings of your church, for in your mercy you have given them to be offered, and by your power you transform them into the mystery of our salvation through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you laid the foundation of the world and have arranged the changing of times and seasons. You formed man in your own image and set humanity over the whole world in all its wonder, to rule in your name over all you have made, and forever you in your mighty works through Christ our Lord. And so with all the angels we praise you, as in joyful celebration we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come, until you come.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Thomas, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by the word of God, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our day, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. The kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sin, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
And may the peace of the Lord be with each of you always. Reminder, Holy Communion will only be given in the hand. Please follow the directions of our hospitality ministers as you come up section by section in single file, and we thank you for respecting the appropriate physical space. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the words, and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you.
My life flows on in endless song, above earth's lamentation. I hear the real, the far off hymn that hails a new creation. No storm can shake my inmost calm, while to that rock I'm clinging. Since love is Lord of heaven and earth, how can I keep from singing? Through all the tumult and the strife, I hear that music ringing. It sounds and echoes in my soul. How can I keep from singing? No storm can shake my inmost calm, while to that rock I'm clinging. Since love is Lord of heaven and earth, how can I keep from singing? What though the tempests round me roar, I hear the truth it liveth. What though the darkness round me close, songs in the night it giveth. No storm can shake my inmost calm, while to that rock I'm clinging. Since love is Lord of heaven and earth, how can I keep from when tyrants tremble sick with fear, and hear their death knells ringing? When friends rejoice both far and near, how can I keep from singing? No storm can shake my inmost calm, while to that rock I'm clinging. Since love is Lord of heaven and earth, how can I keep from singing? The peace of Christ makes fresh my heart, a fountain ever springing. All things are mine since I am his. How can I keep from singing? No storm can shake my inmost calm, while to that rock I'm clinging. Since love is Lord of heaven and earth, how can I keep from singing? No storm can shake my inmost calm, while to that rock I'm clinging. Since love is Lord of heaven and earth, how can I keep from singing?
Let us pray. May the communion in your sacrament that we have consumed save us, O Lord, and confirm us in the light of your truth, through Christ our Lord. I did receive a phone call from Deacon Bob's daughter on Thursday, informing me that he was scheduled to come home from the hospital on Friday. So we ask that you continue to keep Deacon Bob and Nancy in your prayers, especially since this Tuesday is Deacon Bob's birthday. Registration for the New Generations of Faith, grades 1-6, continues to the end of the month. Register online or at either parish office during regular business hours. See today's bulletin or the parish website for the Safe Environment Annual Renewal Process. Even though it may be a while before the customary parish activity returns, use this downtime to be ready for a return to service. There's also plenty of dollars to be matched in the $35,000 matching gift that is on the table for the St. Raphael Remodel Project. Help us reach our goal to begin the first phase of our church remodel. And a reminder that your new or increased online parish support via WeShare can be matched dollar for dollar between now and the end of the month. Please check out the parish website for additional information. I should say that there is $9,900 matching dollars available to St. Raphael. To date, only $3,762 have been matched. That means more than half of that money is available to be matched dollar by dollar when you sign up for WeShare online giving with a recurring gift. A one-time gift doesn't count toward the matching funds. Thank you for your attention to maintaining the proper protocols that will safeguard the health and well-being of us all. And after Mass, be sure to follow the directions of our hospitality personnel in exiting the church once the ministers have left. A reminder that your worship aid is one-time use only. If you like those songs, take it home with you. Otherwise, be sure to dispose of it properly. And be sure to pick up a parish bulletin if you want to know how I spent my summer vacation. Next weekend, our combined parish family will mark the patronal feast of Our Lady of the Valley, the Assumption of the Blessed Virgin Mary, at our weekend masses. Next weekend, when we gather, we will celebrate the feast in honor of the Assumption. The Lord be with you.
And
may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. The Mass is ended. Go forth in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
All the ends of the earth, all you creatures of the sea, lift up your eyes to the wonders of the Lord, for the Lord of the earth, the Master of the sea, has come with justice for the world. Break into song at the deeds of the Lord, the wonders God has done in every age. From the ends of the earth, all you creatures of the sea, lift up your eyes to the wonders of the Lord. For the Lord of the earth, the Master of the sea, has come with justice for the world. Heaven and earth will rejoice in his might. Every heart, every nation call him Lord. All the ends of the earth, all you creatures of the sea, lift up your eyes to the wonders.